We want to find the product using base 10 blocks. We have 2 tenths times 4 tenths. Because we're working with decimals, we'll define the base 10 blocks as follows. The flat, or 10 by 10 block, equals one whole. The long, or 1 by 10 block, equals 1 tenth. And the bit, or 1 by 1 block, equals 1 hundredth. And because we have 2 tenths times 4 tenths, this means we want 2 tenths of a copy of 4 tenths. So we don't even get a whole copy of 4 tenths, we only get 2 tenths of 4 tenths. To model this using base 10 blocks, or for sketching this on our paper, we'd begin by modeling 4 tenths. And because 1 long equals 1 tenth, we can model 4 tenths using 4 longs. So if we model this on top of the flat, this would be our model for 4 tenths. And now because we want 2 tenths of a copy of 4 tenths, we'll now cut our partition 4 tenths into 10 equal pieces, and then take 2 of them for 2 tenths of 4 tenths. So let's go ahead and cut our partition this vertically, and we'll go ahead and cut our partition the entire flat. So 1, 2, 3, and so on. We could just cut our partition the 4 tenths, but you'll see in a moment why I'm doing it this way. Again, because we want 2 tenths of 4 tenths, our product would be 2 of these 10 partitions. And again, we could just shade 2 partitions of the 4 tenths, but let's go ahead and shade 2 partitions of the entire flat, which would look like this. And if we do it this way, the double shaded region represents our product. Notice how the flat is one whole, cut or partitioned into 100 equal pieces, and the double shaded region is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 of those partitions, which means our product is 8 hundredths. 2 tenths times 4 tenths equals 8 hundredths. Notice how by showing it this way, this resembles the paper folding method that we did when multiplying fractions. But if we go back to the previous slide, I do want to show that if we decided to just partition the 4 tenths, not the entire flat, we could have shown it this way as well. Again, here are the 10 equal partitions of 4 tenths. Because we want 2 tenths of 4 tenths, we would shade 2 of these 10 partitions. And notice how, of course, the result is the same. We still have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 hundredths. But by cutting or partitioning the entire flat, and then shading 2 of those partitions, we can always look for the double shaded region to find our product. I hope you found this helpful.